Hi, I'm Abby. Welcome to the Kelku Review Show. Today, we're going to be looking at accessories. Now, if you're an avid filmmaker or photographer, you will know that there are a lot of accessories on the market. Billions, millions, trillions. We have three here today to show you. I'm just going to take you through the pros and cons of each one. So first up, we have an accessories bag made by Amazon, weirdly enough. This is for all your lenses, SD cards, things like that, tripods, lots of zips, lots of zips. Wow, look at that. See, basic waterproofing on the inside here, which is great. It feels quite satisfying. And these are movable, good padding, lightweight, £25, which, if you're just starting out, you've just got a couple of bits and pieces. I think it's really good. Also, it's not too garish. Like, looks all right. And on the side here, sorry, for your tripod. And another pocket on the other side there as well for your lens cloths or whatever else you want to put in there. This is what the back looks like. An extra strap there to go around your waist. I'm going to put it on to show you just how good I look wearing it. Probably looks quite big, but it's just because I am very short. Small, it's very comfortable. It's got padding, £25, I'd say. Yeah. Yeah, if you're looking for something simple, it's very good. Next up, we have the Canon Selfie ES30, portable photo printer. I'm going to show you a little bit how it works and then talk about the product. So, in with an SD card, turn it on all the other way, depending on the way you like to do things. Okay, so we're just going to flick through some photos that we took earlier. There we go. I'm going to select that one, and I'm going to print it. Don't put your hand over over that part. Well, that will happen. So what's happening here is it's putting all the different layers of colour onto the photo. And already it's taken quite a long time. Maybe I don't really have the patience for it. One of the features of this is that the paper and the ink are in the same cartridge, in the same piece, which looks like this, but with paper in. So as you can see, this is what you're left with once it's run out. It's quite a lot of wastage. It is recyclable, but still, for those environmental people out there, I'm not sure it's going to appeal to you. Let's see how we're getting on down here. I think we're just a couple more seconds. There are other features on this. If you go through the menus, it is very simple to work, actually, where you can put frames on, heart borders, thank yous, invitations. It says invitation. They're preset borders, teddy bears, that sort of thing. So here we have just the plain basic picture here, postcard size. And on the back, it does have the little postcard thing as well. There we go. And that's our lovely Jo looking quite spectacular, I think you'll agree. And what I did earlier as well when I was playing around was I managed to zoom in on Jo's face and put in some clip art. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. He's going to be really pleased with this one. I might send it to his mum. Good. And again, you can put in, just to show you one more, little flowers or whatever you think is relevant to the picture. So in the side here, I'm just going to pick up this product. In the side here, if you push this, that's where the ink and printer go in. So you can buy 100 prints for £29, which works out at 29p per picture. So it's not that cost effective. The actual product is $99.99. So if I think this is good if you just print off a few photos quite regularly. But if you're looking to print off hundreds of pictures over and over and over again, you're better off going on the internet, really. Also, looks-wise, I think it is actually quite bulky for a portable product. That is quite big. So if you want something quick, simple, that's great. But if you want something that's going to print for you, it's not really the product for you, I don't think. Next up, we have the Hammerstar 62 tripod, which looks like this. I'm just going to turn it around for you so that it's the right way. So this is a lightweight tripod, very basic, very easy to use. You can extend the legs just by taking these out here. They extend quite a lot, actually. And in fact, I think they extend even more than this, do they? Yeah, there we go. I just learned something while doing it. Special. There we go. Okay, and just one more. Bear with me. There we go. So that's what it looks like fully extended. And here you have the pan handle, which isn't very smooth, actually. And so if you're using it to record film, it's going to be quite jolty. Probably good if you're just starting out filming, if you're just sort of going around initially doing it, you probably quite like this product. But if you're a more serious filmmaker, I don't think you'd be very happy with this product. It is under £14, so it is. I think you're getting more than your money's worth for it. It's even got a little spirit level on the side, so you can play around with that. If I was a little bit more skilled, I probably would have got that straight off the bat, but I'm not. I think this tripod would be really good for a stills camera. Like I said, because the panning isn't very smooth. Also, because the great thing about it is that it is really lightweight, but also that's not making it very sturdy, I don't think. So this hook here is for the extra weights that you can buy with the product. However, if it was me, I'd just put a bag on it and put some rocks in it. I think that would do the trick. I hope this has been helpful. And for more information and reviews, please look at the website. Thank you.